Hello friends, this video on biological classification part 14 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So now we are going to talk about the next kingdom, that is fungi. Now fungi is going to be a very important kingdom in terms of its diversity, in terms of its variety, and also we will see that here the organisms will have a very specific life cycle in terms of their modes of reproduction. So let us see, as we go ahead we'll get to know more about fungi. Well, now before we start our discussion on fungi, first let us see where do we commonly see fungi. There are certain organisms which we actually come across in our day-to-day life, but we do not know that they are fungi. So let us look at some common examples of fungi. Have you ever seen that when a vegetable like a tomato rottens, what happens? You see these kind of thin hair-like structures growing out around it, right? So what is that? That is nothing but fungi. Similarly, you would have, I think many of you must be having mushroom as a part of your food because it is considered edible. So what is this mushroom? Mushroom is nothing but a fungi. Similarly, a rotten orange, again, it gets covered with, the orange color disappears and it gets covered with a creamish greenish color. So what is that growth which happens on the surface of the orange? That is nothing but fungi. So these are some of the fungi which is always present somewhere around us. So now in this topic we are going to study about the fungi in details, their nutrition, their mode of reproduction, their structure, cell wall. So we are going to talk about all such stuffs. So let us first talk about the general characteristic of fungi. Now fungi are eukaryotes, that is they have specific membrane bound cell organelles and distinct nucleus. Multicellular, that is made up of multiple cells. However, there is an exception to it, that is yeast. So yeast is a unicellular fungi. Other than yeast, all other fungi are multicellular. So do you see that there is a promotion? When we started with the first kingdom, that is Monera, they were prokaryotes, unicellular. Then we went to the next kingdom, Protista, they were eukaryotes but still unicellular. But now we came to fungi, they are eukaryotes and multicellular. So as we go ahead with each kingdom, we see that the complexity of the organisms increases, because if the organisms are multicellular, obviously they are going to be more complex, because now one cell is not going to perform all the body functions. Okay, so the next property is they are heterotrophic, depend on others for their food. So they are not able to prepare their own food, they always depend on others. Now how they depend on others, that again depends whether they depend on the dead and decaying matter being saprophytes or they are parasitic. That we will see little later as we talk about each of the groups under fungi. They prefer warm and moist places to grow. That is why you would have seen that when something gets rotten, right? Maybe you would have seen when a vegetable or something gets rotten, it becomes, the moisture comes over there, right? So because of the presence of moisture, more and more fungi grow there, because they want warm and moist places for their growth. At the same time, you would have seen that in order to keep something fresh for a longer time, maybe if you have cooked something today, you want it to be fine till tomorrow or till day after tomorrow. So what do? We generally keep those stuffs in the refrigerator. Why? Because the temperature inside the refrigerator is very low. So at such low temperatures, fungi cannot grow. So the food will remain fresh. But if you keep the same food outside, since outside the temperature would be higher, so in that warm environment, fungi might grow. They are found in air, water, soil, on animals and plants. So again, bacteria, fungi, these are such organisms which can be found almost in all kinds of places. They are immobile, that is, they do not move from place to place. So they are stagnant at one place. And that is what is a difference between the fungi and the slime molds. And that is why slime molds were not put under fungi, but they were put separately under the protista kingdom. Cell walls are present, and the cell walls of fungi are made up of chitin. So with this basic information on the general characteristics of fungi, let us now talk about the structure of fungi. Let us see how does the cell wall look like, what is there inside the cytoplasm of the cell. So let us talk about the structure. Now, most of the fungi grow as hyphae. What are hyphae? A new term here. So hyphae are long, slender, thread-like structures. So here you can see in this picture, this is fungi, right? So what do you see? You see small, something in white color, small thread-like structure in white. And at the top, you see a black blob kind of a structure. So that is what you can see from this figure. So these long, white, thread-like structures, they are nothing but hyphae. So whenever a fungi grows, it grows as hyphae. So you see it as a net-like structure. Even if you see it in your real life, it will appear as a net-like messy structure. So those thin structures are known as hyphae. Interconnected network of hyphae forms mycelium. So now each of this hair-like structure is a hyphae, and many hyphae together, which forms a web-like structure or a mesh-like structure, that network is known as mycelium. So mycelium is a very important term when we talk about the structure of a fungi, because whenever we'll talk about the structure, we will talk about the mycelium, because the structure of mycelium is different in different types of fungi, because again in fungi also you have different categories. So, and those categories differ from each other in their structure, and structure means their mycelium. Okay. Now, cell wall is made up of chitin and polysaccharides. So this is the composition of the cell wall, and this is a speciality of fungi. So fungi are the only organisms whose cell wall are made up of chitin. So they have got a relatively rigid cell wall. Okay, so now if you want to look at the structure of the hyphae in detail, so this is how it will look like. So here you can see this is how the mycelium looks like. Each of these slender structure is a hyphae. Network of hyphae, the overall thing is a mycelium. Now if you try to, what is there inside the hyphae? Inside the hyphae, we have a normal cell structure. So the hyphae inside the hyphae, there are nothing but cells. So the cell will again have cytoplasm, it will have the different cell organelles, so everything will be there. So this is how it will look like. So this is a magnified image of the internal structure of the hyphae. So here you can see these brown colored structures, they act as walls inside the hyphae. So these walls basically separate one cell from another cell. So this is like from this wall to this wall, this is one cell inside which you'll have everything. You'll have a nucleus, an endoplasmic reticulum, the Golgi apparatus. So these structures are known as septum. So septum are the cross walls present inside the hyphae. So here I have mentioned each of the terms. So first is hyphal wall. That means the outside wall of the hyphae is called hyphal wall. This is septum. Then you have mitochondria. Here is the mitochondria. Then you have vacuole, which is used for storage of food. You have ribosomes, useful for protein synthesis. This small dot-like structure is present. Then you have the nucleus. So this is the nucleus. You have endoplasmic reticulum here. Plasma membrane, again, the plasma membrane is present outside. And the last one is the Golgi apparatus, somewhere here. So basically, when we say hyphae, they look like long thread-like structures, but even internally, it has all the cells. It has the components of all cells, and the hyphae is divided into compartments by cross walls, and those walls are known as septa. But it is not necessary that septum will always be present inside hyphae of all types of fungi. Okay, so we will talk about all those stuffs little later. So this is the basic structure of a fungi. So fungi consists of hyphae, network of hyphae form mycelium, cell wall made up of chitin and polysaccharides. If you look at the internal structure of a hyphae, it consists of cross walls called septum, and other than that, it has all the other cell organelles. Thank you. Please visit www.examfear.com to watch more videos, attempt free online test, get free study material, find tutors and mentors. Thank you once again.